Troubleshooting external disk issues. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I received a rather lengthy question from an individual who was struggling with some issues with an external hard drive. In his case, the drive would work for like 10 or 20 seconds, copying information off of it if it was connected to essentially any Windows machine. But if he took it to a Mac, it worked just fine. Now, that's an odd situation, but it does give me some things that basically led me to create this list of things to try, things to help diagnose external drive issues when you're having those kind of problems. So, first up, number one, with a bullet, backup. Hopefully, you understand that if the data is only on that external hard drive you're having trouble with, you are at real risk of losing it completely. So hopefully you've been backing up as you've gone along. However, if you haven't, before you perform any diagnostic steps on the disk, back it up as best you can. In the case of my questioner, since the disk was working when connected to a Mac, that's easy. Copy all that data off right away, store it somewhere on the Mac, and we can restore it to some other place when we're done. But if you don't have that option, copy off what you can, but realize you're probably going to lose the rest. Number two, check disk /F. So what I'm going to do here in Windows 11, I actually have an external hard drive, or a faux external hard drive, if you followed any of my videos before, that I will use as my example. Let's assume that it's having trouble. The very first thing that I would do with that external hard drive is actually a CHKDSK /F. And in my case, that's drive E. What that does is it checks the file system, the data on the hard drive, to make sure that the file folders aren't corrupt, that pointers that point to things are pointing to the things that they're supposed to point to. All of the information about where your files are literally stored on that hard drive is correct, or if incorrect, potentially fixed. Now, in this case, I have nothing on that drive, so it happened very, very quickly. No further action is required. In a case where the disk is working in one situation, as in our original question, then I'm not really concerned about physical issues. I'm not really concerned that there is something wrong with the hard drive itself. It worked when connected to a Mac. It's only when it's connected to a PC that it's failing, which is odd. So, if, on the other hand, you have reason to question the hardware or the disk media, then I would repeat this with /R. Now, I'm not going to do that right now because it takes time. /R will try to read the entire disk media and map out any sectors that it might be having troubles with. After a /R or after a /F, definitely try the problem you've been having before. If it's gone away, count your blessings, back up the data if you hadn't already, and move on. On the other hand, if things are still failing, we're going to get a little bit more aggressive in a slightly different way that you might be used to. Normally in situations like this, one of the things we would say is, okay, fine, the drive is not working, let's reformat it. Let's format drive E. While that does erase and rebuild everything that's on that partition, it actually doesn't change the overhead information that's stored on the hard disk about how many partitions there are, or how big they are, or where they should be. That too could potentially lead to the kinds of symptoms we're dealing with here. So what I'm going to do now is right-click on the Start button, click on Disk Management. And you'll see here that at the bottom, I have my faux USB drive. Your drive may have multiple partitions. Most external drives don't. Some might, depending on their history. If yours does, what I'm going to suggest you do is the same for each partition. And that is simply this. Right-click on the partition and click on Delete Volume. You'll get a warning that you're about to lose everything, and I've mentioned this a couple of times already. Do that for each partition that is present on that external drive until you have something that looks a lot like this. The entire drive is simply unallocated. Now we're going to right-click on it and click on New Simple Volume. That will rebuild the partition table for this external drive. This gets us the wizard. Let the partition take up the maximum amount of space. That's the default. You don't need to do anything here other than click Next. Sign the following drive letter. That's fine. There's really nothing else to do here. Now, format the drive with the following settings. The first thing I'm going to do is change the volume label so that it shows up as my faux USB when I mount it in the future. Reformatting it as NTFS is a fine thing to do, and you should do that and see if that resolves the problem. If it does not, however, come back and this time reformat that drive with exFAT, exFAT, as most people refer to it. That's a different file system. It's actually designed to be both Microsoft independent and better at being cross-platform compatible. If the situation were reversed, the drive was working well on a PC and having troubles on a Mac or some other system, this is probably one of the first things I'd look at after having saved the data. But it is a different file system, so it could expose or sidestep any file system specific problems related to NTFS. Quick format is fine, but again, because we don't think this is a hardware issue, because we think this is just about how the data is being stored on the disk, a quick format will reset everything we need to be reset. And indeed, when we click on Finish, it's pretty quick. There it is, our faux USB drive E ready for use. Again, if it works, great. You're done. Carry on. If it doesn't, now we need to get into what I consider to be scary territory. It's not something I recommend often. And in fact, I can't really say that I'm recommending it now, but I want to throw it out as an option. First, make note of the date and time you're experiencing a problem when that problem happens. Then we're going to go to right-click on the Start button, the Event Viewer. You may have heard me talk about the Event Viewer quite a bit in the past, mostly because it's a mess. It's often used in online scams. It's really something that is meant to be understood only by the developers of software, the folks who are like waist deep in this stuff. But it is possible, I won't say likely, but it is possible that there could be something interesting in the Event Viewer related to the problem you're having. Where you go is here in Windows Logs. We'll expand that, and we'll look at two different logs. We'll look at the application log, and you can see there's a bunch of events that have been listed here, and the system log. Go to the time that you noted the problem you are having, and just look to see if there's anything interesting in the log that makes sense to you. A lot of stuff won't. It's very possible you'll find nothing that makes any sense. But on the off chance that there is something there, this is one of the things I would do and see if maybe there's a clue. Do not be confused or concerned by the number of entries, the number of warnings, and even the number of errors. A normal, well-running system will include both warnings and errors in the Event Viewer. So ignore those, ignore that indication, and simply take a look at the information here that shows up in details for each event to see if it might somehow relate to the external hard disk you're having trouble with. If you don't do this, that's fine. If at the end of everything you choose or not choose not to do, the drive is still not working, this is probably where I throw my hands up and I say it's time to replace the drive. Hopefully, that gives you some interesting things to look at when you're diagnosing a disk problem. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/172449. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.